Move over, Microsoft Word. There's a new sheriff in town when it comes to writing proposals, plans, specs, and docs with your team. With the latest wave of Copilot for Microsoft 365, you get access to Copilot Pages, which upgrades Copilot into a multiplayer AI environment. Now with Copilot Pages, you can go directly from a Copilot prompt to getting work done with your team in seconds. Intrigued? Let's dive in. Now to access Copilot Pages, first go to Copilot, which you can access from the following website. You can click on the card in the top right or the link in the description below. Or you can open Copilot in your Microsoft Teams app. Now, Kevin's asked me to put together a project charter for a new YouTube video. So we need to create a prompt for Copilot to help us get started. A prompt is a set of instructions or questions to get what we want out of Copilot. Here, I'm asking Copilot to literally draft a project charter with a script outline and a project schedule. I also have some information in my OneDrive on Copilot Pages. I can include it in my prompt by pressing space and then the slash key to search my OneDrive. I'll use the arrow keys to select Copilot Pages Brief and press enter. I'll press enter again to submit. And in just a few seconds, we've got a great first draft. We've got the charter up top. We've got the script outline and a project schedule. Normally, you'd need to copy and paste this into a document to start making edits, but Microsoft has now made this seamless with the button Edit in Pages. This button launches Copilot Pages, and we now have an editable page which contains the entire Copilot response. So let's clean this up into a real charter. We can remove the parts where Copilot is talking to us. Let's also change the title, which you can see is based on our original prompt. In this case, I really like the title suggested, Project Charter YouTube Video on Copilot Pages. And let's remove the existing heading here. Now you might have guessed that this is a page inside of Microsoft Loop, which means you get all the same formatting capabilities. For example, I can type the pound sign a few times to make a heading. If this is your first exposure to Microsoft Loop and you're wondering where your ribbon went, don't worry, there are two main ways to make format changes. The first way is to highlight any text in the page and then use the menu which pops up to make the change. The second is to start a new paragraph and press the slash key. This gives you a ton of options to design the page how you like. If you want to learn more, check out our tutorial on Microsoft Loop in the top right. We'll scroll to the bottom and check out the project schedule. First of all, it's pretty cool that this table is now dynamic. You can sort it or filter it using these icons above. Let's scroll to the right to find the task owners. Next, we'll expand the table so we can see all the columns. Let's share this page with these owners using an at mention. I'll select Kevin's name for the script writing task and press the at key. Then click on Kevin's name. To notify Kevin that I've tagged him, we'll click the plus sign. Then we'll click share and notify to give him access to this page. I've gone ahead and tagged the rest of the owners, including myself and Adele. Let's shift gears and look at this from Adele's perspective, starting with the invitation to the page. Here we are in Adele's inbox. We can see we've been mentioned in the project charter page. And Outlook takes us directly to where we've been tagged. Adele has all the same editing capabilities here. So for example, she can turn project schedule into a heading. And if we go back to my view, you see the change has already been made. In fact, we can even see Adele editing here live. Now that Adele and Kevin have access to this page, let's finish the charter. We still have a live Copilot chat, so let's ask for a project budget. Well, the dollar amounts are a bit off, but we know how to edit this, right? Click on Edit in Pages to add this to the existing page. I'll scroll down so you can see the table and also update the heading. Next, I want to get my manager's comments on what we've produced so far. The traditional approach would be to copy all of this and put it into a Word document so that I could then send it through email. But it's 2024 and we've got better ways to do this. Back in Copilot Pages, click on the share icon in the top right. Now I can send a link to this page or I can copy the whole thing as a live component. You can configure permissions for this link by clicking on settings. Let's make sure this just works for our manager. We'll type her email alias here and click on her name. Then let's make sure it's read-only. Then click apply and the link is copied. Let's now go to our email. We'll start a new message to Miriam and we'll paste the link we just copied. This inserts the entire page into the message. Let's ask Miriam for feedback, add a subject quickly, and perfect. We will send it off. Now we're in Miriam's inbox. Let's look at what she sees. Now she's got a read-only view of all this content. And if she tries to forward this to someone else who doesn't have access, they won't see this page. So she has to give feedback through email. But what if she wants to open this page outside of the Outlook window? She can click on the link at the top to open Microsoft Loop. Even though we started this from a Copilot chat, this page conceptually lives within Microsoft Loop. This page is not part of any workspace, but you can add it to one using the icon in the top left. But until then, you can always access this page from your recent list. Now you've seen how you can give your team a much needed upgrade with Copilot Pages. Give us a like if you learned something, and if you have a cool way to use Copilot Pages, leave us a comment to inspire others in our community. I'll see you next time.